This podcast is available thanks to the Access Internet Radio Project, funded by New Zealand On Air. Nice one.
Ciao, benvenuti alla cartolina di cultura e vita italiane, per chi ricorda l'Italia o per chi la sogna. Welcome to the postcard of Italian culture and life, for those who remember Italy or who dream of it. Cartolina is produced in Christchurch, New Zealand, under the patronage of Società Dante Alighieri, and is supported by Cracroft Chase Vineyard. You can listen to Cartolina on air through Plains FM 96.9 or everywhere in the world through the website www.plainsfm.org.nz, either live or via podcast. Buon ascolto! Cari amici, I'm Vilma Larin.
And I'm Dennis Walker.
Today at Cartolina we have an Italian friend, Viviana Zanetti. Benvenuta a Cartolina.
Benvenuta.
Thank you.
Viviana, you have done a lot of things since you came to live in Christchurch. But originally, where are you from in Italy?
Actually, I was born in Treviso, in Veneto, but I spent half of my life in Ferrara, where I studied at university and then where I worked and I met my partner.
And how long have you been in New Zealand?
We arrived in April 2013, so it's just a little bit more than 2 years.
So this was after the earthquake.
After the earthquake. Yes.
You missed all the fun.
But can we just go back a little bit? Because what were you studying in Ferrara?
Law. I have a law degree.
You studied law?
Yeah, I have a law degree and then a PhD in constitutional law.
Ah.
And so what were you doing exactly? Still at university,
yeah,
working there?
I worked at university for 7 years. They were all temporary jobs as a tutor and project coordinator for some classes there. And then we decided to move to New Zealand.
And what brought you to New Zealand? Was it earthquake related? Is it? We always ask this question.
Actually, we weren't so happy about our job situation in Italy. Massimo was self-employed. He's a geologist. And I had this temporary position at university. And I wasn't able to see any future for me at university. So we started thinking that perhaps it would have been better to change something in our life. And also we were very curious about the world. So we started thinking about moving somewhere else. And New Zealand seemed to us the right country to start from, because we read about the skilled migrant category for the work visa. Aye. And both of us were into the shortage list, so we thought that it would have been easier for us to come to New Zealand. So we came here as visitors at the beginning. So we arrived in April and we traveled all around New Zealand, so we enjoyed the country a lot. And in 2 months, Massimo was able to find a job in Christchurch, so we came back from Auckland to Christchurch.
Excellent, excellent. And in fact, I mean, New Zealand is almost the antipodes of Italy.
It is exactly the antipodes.
So you can't go much further.
No.
Because I always say that from Italy, when you come to Christchurch, once you leave Christchurch, you're returning home again.
Yeah.
We're the furthest point you can probably
yeah.
get.
Well, although for your university qualifications, the internet world doesn't seem to be immediately related.
No.
You do a lot and high-level internet things. How did you learn that?
I always worked with the computer. I mean, while I was writing my thesis for the PhD, I was using the computer, obviously, and then helping my professor to do many, many projects. I had to do the editing for the flyers for the projects and recording and editing and other stuff. So I learned doing things. I didn't attend any class, any courses. But I learned doing things, and
which is the best way, I think.
Yeah. Even if I don't know all the details, obviously. And when we moved to New Zealand, we opened a blog because we wanted to stay in touch with our family, and it was easier to write down all our experience here. So we started writing a blog in 2013 when we came. The blog is very easy to keep, and having a website is it's a smooth transition from the blog to a website.
Easier to have a blog rather than write hundreds of different emails to different people.
Or sending photos to various friends.
Yes, so it's a site, isn't it?
Yeah.
A central site.
Yes. And also for the families, it's very, it's very warming for them to read every morning something from the children abroad.
Yes.
And so every morning they were able to read something that we did the previous day.
Right.
We had done the previous day, and they were very happy about that. Now that we settled down, it's not very frequent for us to write at the blog, because normal life is just normal life. When we arrived, it was everything was so different.
Everything was new,
yeah.
Really, wasn't it then?
And what about this website, Leaving Italy, Living New Zealand?
I have started thinking about the project since last year, more or less, because I am a lady of leisure, I have to say. I don't have a job, and it's quite hard for me to find a job at the moment. But I look after all the bureaucracy and the bureaucratic things related to the migration here. So the bureaucratic things from Italy, the taxes we have to pay there and other stuff, and all the procedure for the visas and everything related to inland revenue and for the family. Also, I'm expert in law, so I can read a law.
You can read right. And understand.
And understand.
I can read too, you know.
Yes, I...
So that was my task in the family. And on the other hand, there are a lot of groups on Facebook of Italians in New Zealand, and there are a lot of people asking questions.
Always the same question, I suppose, always. Because all everybody has the same problems,
yes,
or
exactly.
Yeah. Needs the same information.
And apart from all the information related to the visas that are quite a sensitive topic, because obviously there are people that can do that as a job because they have like a qualification from New Zealand and you can't give information about visas. So apart from that, I try to help these. I always try to help Italians with some issues. So the questions are always the same. And so we started thinking about creating a hub or something like a website where we could give all the information. But we didn't want to give information because we thought, and after I will say why I'm saying we thought that migration is a very personal experience. So you can give advice to people about how you succeeded or how you reached the goal, but it's your own experience. And you can't say this is the path you have to follow to succeed as well.
Yes.
So we wanted something that it was much more closer to a mixture between a website with all the information and a blog with all the personal experiences. And because we thought that describing our experience, clever and smart people could take the tips, the information, links, documents, and things like that. We didn't want to create like a quick and fast site where you can pick up your information and do whenever you want, but you have to read the experiences of the other people.
So it's really a kind of a tool,
yeah,
in a sense, for people to read and then they make up their own mind.
Yeah.
So it's not the quick fix.
No.
No, it's...
That's a clever idea.
It's all... everything goes through our own experience. So Maria Luisa from Dunedin, she has three children and she can speak about school in New Zealand. What can I say? Francesca in Christchurch, she's a teacher, so she can describe the school
system
from another point of view. Elisa in Wellington, she has just bought a house and she can describe how to buy a house in New Zealand that is quite different from Italy, and so on. I had the idea because Elisa pushed me a lot. And Elisa is a friend. She lives in Wellington and she's very energetic. May I say something like that? And she wanted me to create this. And I involved other people, Maria Luisa from Dunedin and Franca from Auckland. They are nice friends, and actually I have to say that when we first arrived in New Zealand, we traveled, and those families, so Maria Luisa in Dunedin, Elisa and Raphael in Wellington, Franca and Federico in Auckland, they all opened their own houses for us. We didn't know, we only got in touch because they have a blog as well. So we contacted them and they invited us for lunch, they gave us tips, pieces of advice, and so they were the right people to help me to do this job because they take care of people as well.
I mean, and now you've taken all of this to the next level.
Yeah.
Because it's a kind of, now that you were describing, it's a kind of virtual house where you invite people and have a conversation. I think this is the thing that really touched my heart when I started going through your website, which is, I must say, full of funny things, very well done, with all these photos and the stories. So even people who are not directly interested into migrating to New
New Zealand may find it very fun because you've recently had a contest between northern towns and southern towns or things like this. But the name, now, Dennis, I would like you to pronounce it correctly because there is a pun, of course, leaving Italy, leaving New Zealand. But can you distinguish the pronunciation of the leaving?
Well, this is because in Italian pronunciation, they come together.
Yeah.
So it sounds like leaving Italy and leaving New Zealand. They sound the same. But it's living in New Zealand. Living, it's short. And leaving.
So
and
it's leaving Italy,
and
living.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Yeah.
Now we
yeah.
got it right. And how often do you receive contribution of people who want to tell their stories or to contribute in any way?
We have just started with this project, and so mainly I have contribution from the people that I already know, like Maria Luisa, that she helps a lot, and Lisa, and other people that are already my friends. I try to involve other people in New Zealand according to their skills, but actually I have to say that they were very, very enthusiastic at the beginning, and then they disappeared.
Ah.
And I don't know.
This often happens. It sounds familiar, yes.
I really don't know if the problem is the way, the style of the website, because I like writing, and a lot of people collaborating to the website like writing. I think that we have a very nice way of writing. Sorry. I'm not very humble.
It's true.
No,
it's true. It's correct.
It's
grammatically
correct.
Syntactically correct. True and fun.
Yes, yes.
And perhaps not all of the people can do that. But I always also think that one thing is giving a very short answer to people asking advice, and another thing is writing down a complex test to describe things.
So,
yes, that's right.
At the moment, there are not so many people involved in the project, even if I try to have other people, because I don't want that. That is my... Everybody can think that is my project. Okay, I had the idea. I have the time to empower and to develop the website. But I would like that the website as a
hub.
As
yeah,
a hub.
You mentioned
yeah.
it as a
and,
hub.
And it's more of a community-based
yes.
thing.
And
it's not...
By the way, it's not just the writing, because
no.
you are producing videos in the style of Le Iene,
yeah.
where two people are interviewed half sentence
yeah.
each.
Yeah.
How did that idea come around?
It also came up because, we are interested in stories. So we are creating the website as a personal stories of people that came here in New Zealand. And also we would like to speak about the other people in New Zealand to tell the stories of these people.
For instance, you have a very long and detailed interview with Italian ambassador, Mr. Carmelo Barbarello, which is very, very interesting.
Yeah, we started with that, actually, with the interview to the ambassador. And we were very, very interested in that because he was new, first of all, but also because of his personal life. I have always been very interested in the diplomatic career, so I was interested in him and his personal life, how the personal life could affect
an impact. Yes, of course.
So he was very open. He was very available. He spoke about a lot of things, very different things, and not in a diplomatic way. It was very interesting because he had his own opinion and he wasn't afraid about telling them. And so there were a lot of information from that interview. And he was speaking about the Italian community. He spoke about the Italian community like two different communities. The old people, the old migrants that came here, had come here many years ago, that has like an idyllic view of Italy. And the new migrants that perhaps left Italy because the situation, the economical situation is not so good, so they had a bad opinion of our own country. And these two communities are not able to
interact.
Connect. It's very difficult
yes. Yeah.
Yeah, because their whole life stories are so different, aren't they?
So we wanted, from that interview, we thought that it would have been interesting to interview Italians and to tell their stories. So we thought about these quick and fast and funny interviews to new Italians came to New Zealand with a format of Le Iene, the Italian program, the TV program. But we also are thinking about interviewing people that Italians that had come here 20, 30, 40 years ago, but in a different format, because they can tell us a lot of interesting things, like how New Zealand was 30 years ago, how New Zealand has changed in the time. So this is the new project we are working on at the moment.
So you'll find that there'll be lots of new stories, but new people will come in and there'll always be something new.
Yeah, we hope so.
I'm sure it will happen like that.
So just to resume, if anybody wants to have a look at this website, should go www.leavingitalyliving.weebly.com.
Yeah.
And what else?
And we have also a Facebook page that is quite informal.
With the same name?
Yeah, with the same name.
So
what do you put on that?
Every morning we try to put a song by a New Zealand author. Could be a Maori song or a Pakeha song. And we try to discuss about news in New Zealand. So, for example, the flag or maternity leaves or things like that, that are news that affect also Italians that live in New Zealand. So we try to do these things.
We should have a look.
Yes. Do have a look. Do have a look at Viviana's website and also the Facebook page.
And we are going to play some of the songs that Viviana has suggested us.
Yes.
Dear listeners, thank you for listening. Our guest was Viviana Zanetti. Thank you for
being
with us.
Thank you for coming. Grazie.
Thank you very much.
Shall we say it all together?
Arrivederci.
Principio di magia fra gli ostacoli del cuore mi si attacca volentieri fra una sera che non muore è una notte da scartare come un pacco di Natale c'è un principio di ironia nel tenere coccolati pensieri più segreti e trovarli già svelati e parlare era principio di energia che mi spinge a pendolare fra il mio dire ed il mio fare.
E sentire fa rumore, fa rumore camminare agli ostacoli del cuore. Quante cose che non sai.